Welcome back to the show. We're with Hall of Fame broadcaster Harry Carey and recently Hall of Famer Mickey Mantle passed away. And I didn't know this, Harry. We were talking. You said that his introduction to baseball was through your voice growing up in Commerce.
Yeah, I was doing St. Louis Cardinal games, and Mickey Mantle lived in Commerce, Oklahoma. And he told me this a number of times. He'd point to me and say, there's a guy who introduced me to Major League Baseball. Because the only broadcast they'd get in Commerce would be KMOX and the big radio network they had. There was no television then. And Mickey would say that all he'd ever see would be Sam Hill, whom, of course, he admired. And that was how he got interested in baseball. So, and then I got to know him well. Of course, the St. Louis Cardinals have spring training in St. Petersburg, Florida, and so did the New York Yankees. So I'd run into Rizzuto a lot, and Yogi Berra, of course, and Mickey Mantle and Billy Martin. We got to know each other very well. You know, nobody could possibly revere the name of Mickey Mantle more than I do. But I hate to see what they're saying. This man was afraid he was going to die young. Nobody in his family lived to be older than 50. And this is a thought he had in his mind. And he wanted to enjoy every moment he had in his life because he figured he wouldn't live long. Well, let me tell you something. Making a story about drinking, I know a lot of people didn't live until they're 63 and never had a drink. Now, Mickey Mantle was a tremendous man. He had fun. He was a happy guy when you went out with him. You'll always stay happy with him. Now, Billy Martin, I think he protected Mantle a lot because, you know, some guy come up there and want to say something derogatorily about him, and, you know, Billy would punch him. But not Mickey Mantle. I think Billy liked to get in arguments more. Another thing, Billy Martin never hit anybody until the guy abused him or Mickey. Then he could punch him.
Are you worried, though, that maybe some of the younger fans, their image of Mickey will be tarnished because of his admission of alcohol abuse?
Well, that's what I'm trying to get to. You know, this man, a lot of people drink. I drink. You drink. To all of a sudden make it a national campaign, what are they going to do, keep you from having a drink now? But, I mean, here's a guy who lived longer while drinking than any member of his family ever did before.
So you never saw him really abuse alcohol when
Absolutely
he drank?
Absolutely not. He didn't abuse anything. He was just a wonderful man who liked to have a good time, always had a smile on his face, would meet you at a bar to buy a drink. You'd buy him a drink. Nothing. I don't know how to explain it. I just think it's unfortunate that it has to be presented in a negative light.
But Mickey was also, he brought that forth, and I think some credit should be given to him for admitting that he had that problem and that he had to deal with it.
Well, how do we know that problem really had? Now, he said he thought that the drinking, if you had taken better care of himself. How many people we know who never get to be 30, 63 years old? So we don't know whether Mickey Mantle would still been living if he'd never had a drink. We don't know whether he'd ever lived to be 63. Right. Nobody in his family ever did.
You admit, Harry, you drink, but recently you've cut back in that area.
Not through the personal preference. I drink non-alcoholic drinks now because it doesn't mix well with my medication, so I can't drink alcohol. But I will fight to defend the right of anybody else to have a drink if he wants to.
Are you feel healthier now that you're not drinking alcohol?
Well, I don't... Anybody... Chris, let me tell you something. If anybody tells you that you can have just as much fun not drinking as you can when you're drinking, is lying. You go to a party, you drink these non-alcoholic drinks or drink water, you can't have quite as much fun as you can the other way. But when you realize, if a guy knows, the doctor tells him, don't drink, then if you go ahead and drink, you're stupid. And I'm not going to be stupid. I figured it out long ago. I'd rather be miserable and alive than very happy and dead.
Simply put, we'll have more with Harry Carey. I want to talk about lifestyle. You crack me up. Sometimes simple is best. We'll be back with Harry Carey. Talk about lifestyle changes and his limited schedule calling games in a moment. Don't go away.
Who leads the cheers? The cup band with the king of beer.
To Chicago's newest member of the Baseball Hall of Fame, Harry Carey, this bud's for you.
He's a bud man and a cup and moving like a young guy there, Harry. How old are you, by the way?
158.
Really? You look good for 158. No, give me the date. I'll figure it out.
Age for me is a chronological number. I know a lot of people who are only 45 years old. They look like they're 85. On the other hand, I know a lot of people who are 85 years old, and they look about 45 or 46. So what difference does it make? I think it's the man's personality, the man's health, the man's enjoyment of life that's important. I can't kid anybody. I have a son 55 years old. Who's got a son who's my grandson who's 27 or 8 years old? And so it's not a question of hiding your age. It's just answering it, so far as I'm concerned, a stupid question with a stupid answer.
I thought it was a funny answer, but you do have a limited schedule. You mentioned your health. How is your health, and how has that affected? I guess you're doing the home games and some limited travel with the
team
this year.
Well, I tell you, the Tribune people have just been outstanding. They let me call my own shots, more or less. Because of my family ties, naturally, the places I like to go to, like St. Louis and Atlanta, and if ever any way I can get near Orlando, I want to go there. And I started the season in Cincinnati on the road, went to New York on the road. I'm here on this Western trip. There's certain places I'd like to go because time gets shorter, and you want to see people that you've known all your life. You never know when it's for the last time.
But you want to keep doing it for as long as you feel it.
Well, I want to die with my boots on. And, you know, this one's bothered me. A great friend of mine, a man I really, really thought the world of, Don Drysdale. When I read about how he died in a hotel room, because nobody else was with him. And on this trip, he's met with my wife, Dutchie's coming with me, just for that reason. I'd hate to think the thought of dying on one of these road trips and nobody would ever know what happened to you for days. So the thought of dying is very prominent.
Do you fear that more?
No. I'm like Mickey Mantle. I think I've had a wonderful life. Drinking hasn't affected my love of the people and the population and my business, the people I work with, the people I have worked with. It's I'm happy about the whole thing, and when the time comes, I'll be ready to go.
All right, as we wind things down, your greatest moments. You've seen a lot of baseball over 50
years.
Well,
I saw Stan Musial's 3,000 hit in Chicago, Mo Drabowski. Then I saw the 5 home runs he hit in a doubleheader. I was amazed, and so was he, to realize that nobody had ever done that before. Then later on, one or two fellas have. And then the 84 playoff victory of the Chicago Cubs, who haven't won anything, and even now, for 51 years, the only division title in 84 and the division title in 88. And that's as close as they've come to a World Series since they played there in 1945 against the Tigers, which is my first year of broadcasting Major League Baseball. Now, you think 51 years is a long time. How about the Chicago Cubs? You'd think the law of averages would have taken care of it.
When do you think it's going to happen? Give us a prediction.
I tell you, I only wish I were younger now for one reason. I am so convinced the Cubs are finally on the right track with a fine president, young Andy McPhail, with a fine general manager, young Ed Lynch, with a fine field manager, young and Jim Riggleman. I think the day has come when the people who are on the spots responsibility on the ball club have to be closer to the age of the players who play for them.